Hello friends and welcome back. It's been quite long not to post a video, but here I am back again with this tutorial. Today we are going to do some coding and it might be very helpful for those people who are out there wanting to fetch Gmail emails with full automation. Some businesses or individuals out there are really interested in getting certain emails and arrange them nicely in Google Sheet. As an example, I'm going to filter out some emails that I received from my second email address called yad6am@gmail.com. So this is the email that I want to fetch into Google Sheet. So I'm going to create a sheet. Okay. And this sheet I'm going to call it like Gmail emails. Okay. Now, to be able to communicate with Gmail, we should create a new script using Google Script Editor. So we click the script editor and this opens. We are going to create a new customized menu over here, like the way how we have tools and data and other menus here. I'm going to create a customized one on this interface. So I'm going to create the function called onOpen. This is a small letter. I'm going to pass the event E. And in here, I'm going to create a variable with the user interface. Spreadsheet dot, we are going to get the user interface, get UI. And then using this variable, we are going to create a customized menu. And this function just accepts one parameter, which is the title of that menu. I'm going to call it Muayyad's menu, which is my name. Okay. Okay, we created the menu, so we are going to create an add item. Add item. Okay, for you to understand what an item is this is the main menu, which is the tools. Each item inside of that menu is called an item, or sometimes it's called a separator, or sometimes it's called a submenu. We are just interested to create an item like this one, create a form with a name of get emails. Okay, the second parameter that it accepts is the function name that does all of that, is that reads Gmail emails. I'm going to call that function as get Gmail emails. Doing all of that, we should just add the interface, add to the interface. Let's test this out. You should be saving the code and you need to assign this project as a name, like get Gmail emails. Okay, to run this, I should mention here the name of the function and then run. Okay, we've got the spelling error. Spreadsheet. Oh, should be spreadsheet app. Okay. So you can see here our menu has been created with a customized item, which is get emails. However, when you press here, it does nothing because that function, which is get Gmail emails, does not exist. So the next step is to create this function. Make sure that the spelling of this is exactly same as this parameter. Okay, now the way how I want to fetch emails. I'm not interested in all my emails, but I'm just interested in emails that I receive from this sender, which is yad6am@gmail.com. So the possible solution is to create a filter using Gmail filters. So you put a criteria that the address should be yad6am, and then you create the filter. Now, each email that comes or that involves this sender should be assigned a new label. I'm going to call it to be processed by Google Apps Script. Create. And you can see it that the last checkbox here, it says that it detected one conversation that is matching with this filter criteria. So once doing that, you can see that this label is now being assigned to this email. Okay, so I'm going to, in my customize function, I am going to create a variable called label to get all the emails that are assigned this label. So we're going to use this Gmail API dot get user label by name. In here you should pass the parameter, which is the newly created label that you've got. You have to make sure that the label is without any errors, the exact spelling, otherwise it would not know what label is that. Okay, we have to get all the threads that are assigned this label. Now you might be wondering what a thread is. You know, Gmail organizes things in conversations and threads. So if you reply back to this email, I'm going to reply just for you to see how things are. Hi friend, well, this is an awakening matter. I am going to call you soon to discuss. Okay, with regards, send. So as you see, the two messages are within this thread. It's one thread. So the labels are actually assigned to the thread, not only to the messages. So when you go here, create a message filter, it will be assigned to the whole thread. So the first thing is to get the threads. And you know, a label can be assigned to so many threads. So I'm going to get all the threads that has that label. Get threads. So this is an array. We should be iterating through every single thread in that. And I'm going to use the for loop for this thing to happen. Iterating variable is I is equal to the thread's length minus 1. I'm going to start from the last element in that array and then go down to the first index. I should actually be greater than or equal to 0. Should stop the for loop once the 0 index is reached. Okay, and then we go down. Okay. So in here, I am going to get the messages that are included in every single thread. So I'm going to create an array of called messages. We should be getting the current thread messages. So get, it should be get messages. Okay, now we have a new array that contains all the messages in every single thread. So we have here in this thread two messages. So we should be reading all the messages to get the information that we want. So in this spreadsheet, the first column will be the date and time of that message. The second column will be the sender details. And the third column will be the subject of that message, and the fourth column is the most desirable item that we want, which is the body content of that email. Body content. Okay, that's good. Okay, so here we have all the messages in this array. We should be iterating using another for loop to get the details of that message. Should be another variable, iterating variable, which is J. I'm going to start from the first element in the messages array, and this J should be less than the messages.length. Messages.length. And then we increment the J variable. Okay, that's cool. I'm going to create another variable for this. Okay, Now I don't want to get the details in here in a for loop, so I'm going to create a new function that accepts the message parameter. So I'm going to call it extract details, and I'm going to pass the message as the parameter. Let's go ahead implementing this function in this Google app script. Okay, function extract details, and I'm going to pass the message. Okay, the first parameter that we want, the first information, is the date and time. So we can assign this to a variable called date time is equal to the message dot get time or get date. Another variable that has the subject of that message, subject text, is equal to the message dot get subject. And then we can also get information about the sender. So we get the sender details, which is equal to the message dot get from. And lastly, we get the most important content that we want, which is the body contents. Message dot, we can get it from the function called getPlainBody. Okay, now we have all these variables with all the required information, but we are yet to add anything inside this spreadsheet. So what we can actually do is to get the active spreadsheet, which is this one. So we can have something like this variable, active spreadsheet, or active sheet is equal to the, now we have to use a spreadsheet app. Spreadsheet app dot get active spreadsheet. Active spreadsheet dot get active sheet. So in this variable we are having the active sheet, which is sheet one, not any other one else, if you've got like so many sheets. So once we press the menu here, we want to include all the information in this active sheet here. So we have this variable, which is active sheet. Then we can use a function called append row to create or insert a new row with all information that we have. In this method, we can pass the parameters or the variables that we have created early. So we here can pass this date time variable. The second variable, or the second parameter in that array, is a sender detail. So we can get the sender details. The third parameter, or the third column, is a subject text, and the fourth column will have the body contents. There is a typo error here, it should be messages. Okay, we are now good to go. We save and can go ahead and click this item. Okay, we should be granting the permission because we are reading the Gmail information, and we are actually modifying the labels, and this is requiring the permission. So as you can see, all the information has been fetched out from the Gmail emails. Isn't that cool? It's really, really cool. Later you can like automate things up, like fetching certain information, parsing this content so that you get certain important information. And this might be really helpful for businesses out there. They might be interested in getting information that the team members send and things like these. There's actually one thing that I have to mention. If you press again this item, you will be fetching the same information back again and again. This is actually not desired because the emails that you fetched are just fetched. No need to really fetch them back again. This is happening because the label is still there for these messages. So what we can do is that we can remove the label out of the thread or out of the conversation. So the next step is in here, in a message, what we can do is we can make it unread if you wish. We should be using the Gmail app, mark as read. This is the first, but we are still able to get all the information again. We should be removing the label. The label is not to be removed out of the message, but out of the thread itself. So out in a top level for loop, in here, we can be using a function called remove label, and we just give the label as a parameter. So this way, delete this one. Okay, now if you press again, you won't get anything because this label is no longer there. If you refresh, you will see that the label is removed. That's why you don't get things up here. Actually, I would also give you another information, which is that if you have many users using the same sheet here, so each time they press on this item, Gmail will ask for permissions because the Gmail emails will be fetched from their accounts. But you want to prevent that. So the way how you prevent is as a possible way, in here you can check which Gmail account is currently logged in and provide the message to the user that they have to log in as that account. So I am only going to run this script if that person is logged in. Now we have to deal with sessions. If session, we get the active user, which is this one, and we get the email. Now, if this email is not equal to my email, which is moa2900@gmail.com, okay, I am going to return, but before doing that, I'm going to show a message. And this message can be shown using the browser.msg box, and you just give the prompt. Please log in as moa2900@gmail.com. This is the way how you do it. I hope that this video is useful to you. I'll see you next time with another video tutorial. Thank you for watching. Happy day to you.